Hi, I'm Andrei, the guy from Romania. last week I was attending at an exhibition back in Bucharest, 100 years of design history, Polish design history. It was amazing. I'm very glad I'm here in Poland now. I will talk about my journey on becoming a designer, and I have some examples, bad examples, a lot of them, and the one good example of using design thinking back in Romania. Some rules for me: keep breathing, smile, and for you, please be patient, because it's my first English presentation. So I have my notes here, if I am stuck. I have three items on me. You can hear me? Sure. So, I was educated as an engineer with mathematics and physics, my most important tools. I used them to understand the physical world around me. I have become very good at this and even won some Olympics in mathematics and physics. But my interest was always for a less concrete area. I was passionate about aesthetics. So I became a self-educated designer with something that not every designer have: aesthetics, mathematics, and system thinking. I was very close to what Fuller, the definition of the designer given by Fuller. In his opinion, it's the designer, it's a mix of artist, inventor, mechanics, economist, and the strategist. I was born in Brasov, in the heart of Transylvania. And I moved to Bucharest and start working in the advertising world. Back in those days, the designer or the concept of a design studio was unthinkable. Even now, we are seen like a strange people with a lot of post-its and arts around us. In the advertising world, I worked on a lot of decorative works, ranging from two-hour branding identities to integrated communication campaigns with all sorts of mediums. All of them gravitated around the TV. Here are some examples. Chukash beer, it's produced in my hometown. ING Bank, and some food-related brands. Large and medium-sized companies spend enormous budgets on media exposure, but they don't take into account the customers or a customer-centric strategy. They use creatively driven ads, like this one. but they fall into transforming the company, and they promise more and deliver less. So, in very short time, I was grown to the position of creative director, and I have the privilege to manage almost 10 creative teams back in Bucharest, and that was the time when I was starting to question my position and the core of my job. Does it make sense to make an expensive joke to which everybody will laugh, so just they will remember the product or the services that we will try to communicate, maybe. I followed my intuition and gave course to an entrepreneurial journey. It was my biggest step from thinking advertising to a more holistic approach of my projects. A friend of mine said once, a branding process ends when a rebranding process starts. This idea stuck with me, and I believe it's true. If you think about, branding has the goal of building reputation, consistency, and meaning. It's not about a moment. It's about a long-time relationship in which you need to root yourself deeply in a strategic vision of the leadership. Form and function, aesthetic and strategic, they are very known binomial that almost everyone knows. Have you tried to make a form without understanding of the function and the reason to exist of that form? We also have the natural order of things. Research, function, form. Research, ideation, and implementation. I see this order broken almost in every industry back in Romania. There are very few marketing people committed to a metaphorical Bushido code. They are driven by money, they are and without experience, they are jumped from company to company, leaving behind long-term strategic plans. What happens most often when a chief marketing guy arrives in a company? It's a rebranding. So we are left with cycles of branding, mutilated, half-cooked, like in a freak show. So these types of initiatives need to become more flexible and dynamic than before. As a static collection of guidelines and communication and messaging, they fall short in their promise of transforming the way the organization actually works. Identity design is just a piece of what a company needs to become relevant and sustainable. Things look good on paper, the models are logical, but the change, the real change, never happens in these types of companies. And it's partly because some fancy consultants, also like me, are working in the ivory tower, and the strategic platforms are not assumed by the people in these companies. In fact, in Romania, very few branding companies are human-centered or try to co-create in the process. So I knew it. The design was the answer. Everything that we design needs to embody the core meaning that the user are seeking. Delivering meaning cannot be an afterthought. The desire to do so needs to be deeply embedded in the company culture, its mission, its strategy, and the core value of its employees. So, after working in the advertising and branding industry, now I'm a chief designer at Studio Kort, a consultancy firm that uses design methods and human-centered approach to elevate product and services for both public and private sector. The first one. Yes, we are some hairy guys. Everyone have a mustache or a beard. So design has never been more valued as an economic force, nor has it been as culturally influential as it now. All type of organizations are including design in their, all type of organization including once conservative management consultancies, have begun to adopt design as their guiding principle. For more, almost 200 years, the field of design has followed development in business, technology, and culture. The ability of design to adapt in continuously evolving environment is what makes this approach relevant in time of change. In return, the continuing relevance of design has helped to redefine the profile and elevate status of designers in society. It's not me in the picture. All these positive outcomes come with their own downsides. So, design is becoming increasingly multidisciplinary, and many new concepts are now being crowdsourced or co-designed by people who are not trained designers. This means that the role of design leader will no longer be to develop creative or unique solution, but one that revolves around facilitating ideas. Also, as concepts such as design thinking are increasingly gaining acceptance at all level in the business and society, we will see an increasing number of people calling themselves designers, even though they may never have studied design or in my case, practice the design discipline. The rise in popularity of design thinking brought to the field a lot of value, but this may also work against the field, as many and many more people believe that they do not need any qualification or proper training to think like designers. The danger here is that the credibility of our field, of the designer profession, could be negatively affected in the long term. Yeah. The problem with this is that we end up transforming the design experts in some administrative actors with no specific contribution to bring rather than to helping the process with their post-it and maybe at the end some pleasant visualization. In other words, the design process today, it's like a polite conversation at the table in some participatory design exercise. We start with examples now. How we are? So, let me talk briefly about Bucharest Jewish National Theater, where the director found himself at the end of his 4-year term. He wanted to apply to another mandate and had the inspiration to order a market research that will be the basis of the new application. We approached this research by applying design methods and especially involving almost every employee from the theater. We drew up a research design that includes collaborative workshop of business modeling or service design with the core team. And in addition, we have done some shadowing interview with experts and some questionnaire desk and archive research. After nearly 5 months, a 200-page document was produced, useful to both our client and the entire Romanian theater industry. We also offered advice on writing the project, including what we have found in the research. Now, the director has a new mandate, but the design project has stopped without implementation. Here you see the first 90 pages of the document. So my design team was provided what was asked, but without being close to supervising the prototyping and testing cycles, the real change did not happen. And the experience you have in that theater, it's pretty much the same. So you have an example of don't enter signage. Okay. Another example. Follows the trend of building communities and civic initiative groups back in Bucharest. More and more corporations are trying to get back to the community by creating all sorts of civic tools. We talk about private grants for social projects or even rooftop urban garden, for example. A French international retail group, it's one of them. They try to root themselves in one of the Bucharest neighborhood through a community hub. They approach us, to facilitate a one-day workshop in which, together with major actors in the neighborhood, we try to understand the needs of the neighbors and to define a strategy for the hub. Imagine an entire process in one day, design process, with people who are exposed for the first time to such an experience. So against all odds, we were able to generate some good ideas, even though they were based on a superficial empathy. What surprised us the most was the multitude of promotional materials in the space where the event was held. They turned the event into a communication campaign with many cameras, interviews, and a lot of content produced. They turned the community people also felt this, and many left during the workshop. It was amazing. So, in fact, the PR agency has proposed this approach for not for his core value, but for the PR value of the process. We have been fooled, and it's me when I realized this. So, another example of using design thinking for its PR value, like innovation, it's a workshop held for the Forum of Cultural Diversity. That was a project sustained by public grants, and the only concern was how to spend money instead of creating something meaningful. The team on which we worked was very good. The use of cultural diversity as a resource in community development. We were able to bring people from different disciplines and different minorities. Another one. Succeeding to generate some draft ideas. What happened to them? The board has been archived. Some post-it lost during the transport. And now they probably lie in the drawer of the organizer. Pretty sad. Even in the private sectors, companies that use one-day design workshop to solve internal problems are failing in making real improvement in the company. The workshops are not part of a complete design process or a strategic initiative. I call them workshop shows, and they are part of company human resources program that no longer has team building ideas. Instead of call some dancer or some magician or go to the nature, they call two facilitators and the job is done. It's a context in which the employees meet, spend the day together, eat well, and stick some post-it on the wall. It's me, like a horse. So, the main story for today. And it's the good example of using design thinking. So the story begins in Pajura, a neighborhood from Bucharest. Being one of the first local networks developed over 50 years ago, StarNet had the same fate as other private networks in Bucharest, which over the past 5 years have started losing faithful customers, falling under the pressure of the large telecom companies. The local internet provider came to our studio in search of solution to overcome a continuously decline in business. Studio consultants use strategic design methods to tackle the situation, seeking to innovate the operational model of StarNet and the impact it has on the market. So, in order to reinvent a paradigm, a process of empathy and understanding of the context is needed. So, for almost half a year, we did a design research with interview, shadowing, business modeling, and service design workshop, knowing that we cannot go back to the old operating model. Following this audit, we found out that people felt they were receiving prepackaged deals with service that they don't need. And the promise made by advertising campaign are hardly covered. We talk about internet quality, customer relationship, or the speed of intervention in cases of when the problem arose. On the other hand, it emerged that neighbors, although they cared about the neighborhood, had no tools or motivation to get actively involved in the improving the area. A few months later, in the definition phase, the civic-oriented approach has come to life, a platform that gives people the opportunity to pay for internet service with civic and social action. Yes. After the business model was redrawn, the new concept found its name by adding up three important elements at the foundation of the new brand: the internet, the citizen, me, and the activation of the program on. Using the citizen as a main engine, Net Me On, it's a call for those wishing for a change through social and civic involvement. Because it's a sustainable business model, you pay for the router inside your home, and you are plugged for free and forever to a limited fiber internet connection. Once connected, you can anytime unlock the premium custom account by paying for extra services. The payment of the free internet can take several forms, from sending 3 notifications per month through civic alert application, signing petition, or even going to vote. All this type of engagement provide free internet payment or lowering the invoice. So, you might imagine only 600 subscribers to the service who pay through civic alert notification. At a rate of 20% of issues solved, we have almost 40 punctual improvement in the neighborhood. And what you can see below are the notification and of our subscriber who covered holes and on the road or repaired broken traffic lights, paying for our free internet. The vision of this type of engagement is to change the city with the help of the citizens. But looking at things more pragmatically, the idea behind the concept is to make people more aware of of to what's happened around them. The next step following this habit is to of observation is to open the appetite to take action and to make some action that could turn in this content into improvement. NetMeOn, it's a platform for both NGO and civic initiatives, as well to other neighborhood internet networks that want to join this new model. And in practice, the engagement part is outsourced to a non-governmental partners on a monthly basis, with NetMeOn providing the infrastructure through which users get involved. In the new service architecture, there are no prepackaged alternatives. You activate the free internet paid with by civic action, and then you can build your ecosystem as you want by making various updates to the free platform. You have to choose from four updates groups, in which three of them are increasing the bill and one it's intended to reduce the invoice. Okay, things are not just theoretically and conceptual, and I will move quickly through what we have done in almost 2 years. We choose to activate the concept in Bucharest in its beta phase in order to test and refine the assumption made in the service design. This was achieved through a dedicated 3-month program for testing involving a representative sample of citizens. Their home were connected to the new service and they gave feedback on a weekly basis depending on the specific scenario tested on them, the intervention, the payment through engagement, or various speeds. We earned some free media exposure thanks to the new concept, and here I am at the radio. We are in contact with various NGOs that provide the task that pay for the free internet. We implement the concept in all the level of the company. We set up the first civic initiative group in the neighborhood and one of the largest network of similar group from Bucharest. And they fight for illegal construction or to rehabilitate one of the most beautiful buildings in the area. We also launched Update Me, a physical magazine where 80% of the content is created by the citizen living in the first district. It tackles topics which are at the intersection between technology and social responsibility, transforming proactive and aware citizens into editors and collaborators. So, NetMeOn can also be seen as another method of paying for the services we use. Imagine paying for your water and for your electricity through civic involvement. At the time when businesses are becoming more and more aware of having to return to the community, we choose to do this not through specific CSR project, but through every action taken by the company through the operation. So we used the infrastructure and database developed by a private operator to build an approach that it brings good to the whole community. This is a good example where all stages of design process have been applied, from initial research to idea generation to testing and implementation. I will jump off. And some takeaways for you. So, how to make a process of change? You need to involve people, both internally and externally. Implement things, please. Don't stop at a research or idea generation. Work with the culture and for the culture, for internal culture. assume that you have a role of educating people and don't stretch the program. So the timing is very important. Some takeaways for facilitating workshop. You need to stand up in your feet. Use on the post-it icon and text. They are very useful to see them from apart. Prepare for the workshop and choose a space with natural light. For organization, work with design studio. Put designers at the table in the earlier stages of a project. Don't make one-day workshop. They are not, it's a team building. So, and make complete cycles of design. And some things for be a better human being. Educate yourself, observe, act when after you observe something. Have various friends from all level of society and experiment and take challenges like me on now. Mulțumesc!